The Image Trace feature in Adobe Illustrator is the quickest way to convert your image to vector format for high-quality printing at any size. Unlike raster images, vector images are made up of mathematical pads that allow the design to be scaled infinitely while retaining its quality. To get started, open an image in Adobe Illustrator. Select Window, Image Trace to bring up the Image Trace panel. With your image selected, check the Preview box to preview the effect. Under Mode, you can choose between color, grayscale, or black and white. Select the mode that best suits your design. For our design, we'll choose color. The first slider in the Image Trace panel will control the amount of colors, grays, or threshold depending on the mode you've selected. If this is too low, it might make your image too plain. And if this is too high, it could make your image too complex. However, this all depends on your specific image. Since we have a relatively simple image, we can take the color slider to the max of 30. Next, click the Advanced dropdown to reveal some more options. First, there is the Paths slider. Having too few of paths can distort your image or cause it to look boxy, while having too many paths can make the edges of your image very rough looking. It's best to try and find a happy medium. For our image, we'll go with 50%. Next, there's the corner slider. Less corners will make the pads of your image smooth, while more corners will make the pads of your image a little more pointy. Depending on your image, adjust the corner slider until it's looking good. For our image, we'll go with 80%. Finally, there is the noise slider. This tells Illustrator to ignore areas of your design that fit within the given pixel size. This means a higher number will actually result in less noise. However, if it's too high, important parts of your design could disappear altogether. For our image, we'll go with 15 pixels. When it all looks good, click the Expand button. You can now save your image as vector format AI, EPS, or PDF file. Your artwork is now infinitely scalable and can be printed perfectly at any size. That completes this tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to let us know in the comments. Be sure to check out our other design tutorials. And if you found this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos.